Class 6, welcome to your science class. Today we are going to begin with a new chapter, that is chapter number 9, movement in animals. So let's start with part 1. The learning checklist for today will be movement, locomotion and movement in different types of animals. Let's start with movement. There are different types of movements that are shown by all the animals. Some animals hop, some animals swim, some animals fly, while some creep. So why do animals need to show these different kinds of movement? Animals move in search of food and shelter. Unlike plants, animals are dependent on others for their food. So they need to move here and there in the search of food as well as shelter. Animals move around to escape from their predators. The predators who can hunt them. So to save their lives, they need to move. Animals move around for reproduction. Movement also affects body circulation, digestion, respiration and other such metabolic activities. Movement also boosts immunity. Moving any part of body while sitting at one place is known as movement. But when an animal changes its place and moves from one place to the another, it is known as locomotion. Now let's discuss movement in different kinds of animals. Different types of bones and muscles work together for helping us in locomotion. And different types of animals will have different type of body structures for their movement. So there are two categories of animals based on the presence or absence of backbone. So not all the animals possess backbones in their bodies. There are also some animals which do not have backbones. So the first category is vertebrates. Vertebrate is that group of animals that have backbones in them, for example humans, cats, dogs, tiger, etc. And the second category is invertebrates. Invertebrates are those animals who do not have backbone inside their body, for example snail, worm, cockroach, etc. Let's discuss few of those animals one by one now. Movement in earthworm. Earthworms do not have hands and legs for their movement. So they lack skeletal system along with lacking limbs. Continuous expansion and contraction of muscles is the reason how movement of earthworm is carried out. And the kind of movement that is shown by them is known as crawling. An earthworm's entire body is divided into segments. Segments are the ring-like structures which are present on the body of an earthworm. And below their body are some special hair-like structures which are known as setae. These setae helps in the movement of the earthworms from one place to the another. For its movement, the earthworm first fixes its rear portion onto the ground with the help of its setae, and then it extends the front part of its body. Then the earthworm fixes the front portion to the ground and releases the rear end. So this alternate contraction and relaxation of the muscles helps the earthworm to move from one place to the other very slowly. While its movement, earthworms also secrete a slippery and slimy substance which is known as mucus. Mucus helps them to slide easily onto the ground. Now moving to another organism, that is the snail. Snails are known for their very slow movement. The average speed of a garden snail is 1 millimeter per second. That is very little. Snail carries a hard shell on its back, which is its exoskeleton. Exoskeleton is the type of skeleton which is present outside its body. So remember, snail do not have a backbone. It does not have any kind of bone inside its body, but it has an exoskeleton which is in the form of a hard shell which is present on its back. This shell provides its protection from the weather conditions as well as from its enemies. Snail glides along on their muscular foot, which is lubricated with mucus. So this muscular foot shows a wave-like movement and it releases mucus, which is again a slippery and slimy substance which makes the movement of its body very easier on any surface. So mucus offers a smoother surface to crawl upon. So the body of a snail consists of a head, a pair of tentacles, and a long muscular foot. The tentacles have eyes upon them. So you can see the snail moving here on its thick foot. This thick foot is made up of strong muscles, and as it moves you can see a mucus trail left behind. This mucus makes the movement very easy and prevents injury in a snail. Movement in cockroach. Cockroaches are versatile creatures which can show a variety of movement. They can walk, swim, climb, and sometimes fly to a shorter distance, scaring the other people. Cockroach has 6 jointed legs and 2 pairs of wings. It is called jointed legs because they are joined at one particular place. It uses strong muscles for the movement of its wings to fly. They are able to fly for only a shorter distances. Movement in fish. Fish are vertebrates, means they have backbones inside their body, and they are aquatic animals, means they are living inside water. So fish has well arranged skeleton system which is covered with very strong muscles. The streamlined body of the fish allows the fish to move easily inside water. Now what is this streamlined shape? Streamlined shape is the boat like shape. If you observe the body of a fish closely, you will see that the body is broad at the middle and it's narrow at the two ends, which is similar to a boat. So this streamlined shape helps the fish to cut through the water very easily. Fish swims by moving its body and tail in the opposite direction to each other. In this process, the fins also help in the movement of fish. The fins also have skeletal and muscle support, means they also have skeleton inside it, as well as it is covered with strong muscles. So fins help in keeping the direction and maintaining the balance of the body of the fish while swimming. All the types of fish have a special structure inside their body which helps them to remain afloat or move up and down inside the water. This special structure is known as swim bladder. This swim bladder resembles a lot with a balloon.
To the swim bladder, it can then be inflated or deflated more towards the surface of the water. Of the fish. If he decreases so the gas in the swim bladder, then he will become heavier and sink
towards the surface
in
of the water column. It inflates the bladder and it goes to the top surface. And whenever it needs to go at the bottom, it deflates the swim bladder, means it empties out the air. As a result, it sinks to the bottom of the water column. Moving on to movement in birds now. Birds can fly in the air as well as walk on the ground. There are some birds which are not able to fly, for example, ostrich, emu and kiwi, while there are some other birds which can swim, for example, duck and swan. So the four limbs of these birds are modified into wings. The skeleton of the birds is hollow from within, means it is filled with air to reduce its weight, and the strong breastbone muscles helps them to move their wings up and down, as a result of which they are able to fly. Birds with heavy bone weight cannot fly much higher, such as emu, kiwi and ostrich. Ostrich is also the fastest running bird in the world, and it can run up to 97.5 kilometers per hour. The birds that are able to fly in the air also have a streamlined body shape which helps them to cut through the air. Birds show two types of flight. They either show flapping movement or they show gliding movement. Now, in flapping flight, the wings of the bird are actively flapped up and down, which helps to propel or move the bird forward and to maintain their balance. This can be seen in smaller birds such as sparrows, pigeons, mynas, etc. And in case of gliding movement, the large birds are able to suspend themselves effortlessly in air without flapping their wings. They flap their wings only occasionally. Gliding movement is seen in birds like eagles and kites. Movement in snake. Snakes are thin and long creatures which do not have any legs or arms. They have a long backbone that is covered with strong muscles and skin. Snakes move in a wavy motion. They have scales all over their body and their ribs are free, means their ribs are not attached with each other as in the case of most of the animals. They move in a slithering manner or in a zigzag manner because of the contraction and relaxation of the muscles, which pushes them to the forward direction. Snakes move best on rough surface and they are not able to move ahead on smooth surfaces. So that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.